outsized personality, colorful language to match, but he was gone shortly after the new chief of staff took over. Here's ABC's Cecilia Vega with more.
It was one of the fastest, crudest flameouts in West Wing history. Communications director Anthony Scaramucci, known simply as the Mooch, forced out after just 11 days on the job, the new White House chief of staff, John Kelly, pushing for his departure. Scaramucci, a wealthy Wall Street financier, handpicked by the president and his family, cast himself from the start as a personal friend of the commander-in-chief.
I love the president. I obviously love the country.
But from day one, there was bad blood between Scaramucci and former chief of staff Reince Priebus.
We are a little bit like brothers, where we rough each other up once in a while, which is totally normal for brothers.
It only got worse.
Some brothers are like Cain and Abel. Other brothers can fight with each other and get along. I don't know if this is repairable or not. That will be up to the president.
But then Scaramucci redefined what it meant to go off message. The communications director calling up a reporter and launching into a tirade, calling Priebus a paranoid schizophrenic, threatening to fire essentially the entire White House communications team over leaks, saying they'll all be fired by me. And I fired one guy the other day. I have 3 to 4 people I'll fire tomorrow. He also tore into the president's chief strategist, Steve Bannon. I'm not Steve Bannon, he said, launching into an attack so profane we can't repeat it on television. He said, I'm not trying to build my own brand. The White House said the president, who's used some choice words himself in the past, was none too happy about Scaramucci's comments.
The president certainly felt that Anthony's comments were inappropriate for a person in that position.
The communications director had become the story, his words going viral, his gestures mirroring the president's, mocked on The Daily Show.